I've come to the realization I have really never shown you guys my boat. Sure, you guys have seen it in many videos, me out fishing and stuff on the boat, but I've never really given you guys like a tour of it. I don't know why I haven't. So I'm thinking today is probably a good day to do it, as the fishing season has been really weird lately, guys. It was looking like we were really close to having some ice fishing going on here. I was like, all right, bet. We got ice fishing coming. This is gonna be freaking dope. And all of a sudden, it's 55 degrees out right now. It's a beautiful day. I can't complain about the weather, but like, what the fuck, Illinois? Like, come on, bro. I'm trying to ice fish. And of course, the water temps are very cold and the bass are not gonna be biting. So I'm kind of just screwed. I'm getting double penetrated in every goddamn way. I don't know why I just said it like that. That was really sus. But yeah, I'm thinking a little boat tour for you guys. Maybe I'll go and try some ponds or something. I just don't feel like taking the boat anywhere right now is probably for the best. But yeah, let's check out the BD Bass Tracker, baby. Standing on your big spender, yeah. Hundred on my wrist, yeah. Ooh, standing on your big tip, yeah. All right, boys, well, don't mind these ropes. I actually just tied these up just in case my big shelter here, you know, some wind starts gusting. Keep this baby secured down. But right here, boys, we have a 2019 Bass Tracker Classic XL. I purchased her earlier this year, I think in March. Has been an amazing year on the boat. I'm surprised I haven't given you guys a tour still, but obviously we got started in the last like 5 months here, so. I'm losing my boat tour virginity. This is pretty freaking sweet, boys. But yeah, 17 foot aluminum bass boat. She is, obviously you can't really tell from the bottom, like this easily in here. She is a flat bottom. So when we get those big, thick, fat waves, we are rocking in this boat, boys. I can't lie. Let's check out what we got rocking back here. We've got a 4-stroke 50 horse Merc in the back. When I got her, she had literally like 2 hours on the big motor. So I've honestly been breaking it in for quite some time. It probably is just now getting broken in after the whole season is concluded. She starts up like a charm. Don't have to go through the pain of mixing all these fluids and stuff to make her work. 4-stroke, as simple as it gets, as simple as I need, being that I am a dipshit. Up front, we are rocking a 45 pound thrust Minn Kota Edge. 45 pound thrust might not seem like a lot, but when it comes to a boat this light, being that it's aluminum and it's not absolutely massive, she is perfect for the job. While we're up front, might as well show you guys. Got a little fish finder up front here. It's honestly pretty shit. I need to replace it most definitely. And let's move on to the actual fish finder that I really use in this boat. I've got a Garmin U73 SV. Let me turn that bitty on. Oh, she looked nasty. Overall, this Garmin is pretty freaking sweet at what it does. Includes side imaging and all that, so you can find clumps of bait aside from the boat and such. Really good sonar as well. Just a great consistent reading.
Oh yeah, we got a nice reading. Let's see what depth we're in right now. Probably about 2 feet of grass. Let's see what else we got here. All right, well, we got our live well here. Not too big, but she gets the job done. She is kind of dirty. I need to clean her out because I just had some sauger and some walleye in here from the last video. All right, I'm gonna hop in the boat and show you guys some more stuff.
Alrighty, we are in the slab right now.
Right when you step in, as you can see, some nice comfortable seats so your booty stays nice and comfy on the rides. I also apologize for my organization right now. I got stuff kind of, actually not too much stuff. I just got my life jacket and stuff out right now. I'm gonna fully deep clean this right now, to be honest. I just figured I'd show you guys a quick tour. Right back here in the back deck, we got some tackle storage. I got nothing in there right now. I took in all my stuff because I didn't have it in this big shelter, which shout out my dad for helping me set up this big shelter thing. This thing is freaking sweet. Keeps all the elements out of here. When there was rain or snow or anything, water was kind of getting in here, even with the boat cover. It was frustrating, but yeah, nice tackle storage in the back. Some people opt to put like their life jacket and stuff in here, but I will show you where I put those in just a second. So here's something pretty cool about this boat, actually. So this whole area right here, as you can see, like the lines going around up to there, that is an aftermarket added tackle storage.
So the guy I got the boat from, basically there's a really small front deck that comes stock with this boat. I'll put a picture on the screen. I'll give you guys an idea of what I'm talking about. The guy I got this boat from actually added this aftermarket tackle storage. So here, let me just give you guys a little idea of this. So we got the tackle storage in here. I just have a bunch of soft plastics in here. There's also storage way up in there. That is where I keep the life jackets, as you can see back in there. So yeah, we got some nice tackle storage. We can throw some extra things under here too. I think I'm gonna add a little door right in here because there's also a lot of storage right in there that could be really easy to access if I just add a door here. It really just comes to a matter of keeping all the supports in there so when we're up here, we don't eat shit and collapse while we're fishing. That would simply not be ideal, boys.
But yeah, awesome amount of tackle storage on this boat. For what it is, man, I absolutely love my boat. Another cool little thing, I got some essentials right under these seats. They flip up, so I got like my dildos.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
I mean my fire extinguishers. Sorry, boys, I'm really sus. And then I got some more soft plastics and stuff in here, you know. We're pretty dialed out here in the BD Bass Tracker, I can't lie. Got some little switches right here. Bilge, get the water out of my boat. Aerator, throw some water in the live well. Lights nav for when it's dark out and if you have lights on in the back of the boat. And ANC, I honestly don't know what that means. I have never used it, so. Overall, boys, I absolutely love this boat. When I got it in March, it was literally just the perfect thing to make this season of bass fishing freaking amazing. Yes, guys, I absolutely love this boat. I'm glad I got to finally share and give you guys a little bit of an in-depth tour on the boat. I don't want to cut this video short, though, because I'm like, I don't know. I don't like not fishing in a video. It's kind of like a pet peeve of mine. I don't like watching a video of, like, just a little tour or something. That's just not something I would personally click on. So I think even though the water's kind of cold and there was probably ice in the pond, like, a couple days ago, I think I'm gonna go out and try to catch some bass for you guys. Even if I don't, I think it's worth throwing a little fishing content. Who doesn't like watching a little bit of a dangle?
Signing off from the BD Bass Tracker, boys. What an absolutely gorgeous day to get skunked bass fishing. You know, man, it's really tough, you know, being a bass fishing YouTuber that is absolutely dog shit at bass fishing, but it's fine. It's all part of the process, you know what I mean? I'll improve as we go. Okay, boys, but on a real note, we got a couple baits we're gonna try to catch the bass on today. Got myself a little blade bait action. Gonna cast this baby out deep, you know, rip her off the bottom, see if we can get some bites off her. And second of all, something I literally never throw, to be honest with you. I threw in a little MEPS inline spinner, a little 16th ounce tiny one. See if we can get literally any bites. If I catch a fish today, I'll probably cream my pants, to be honest with you. I also just voice cracked, so meme me in the comments, please. Probably. Almost 21 years old, still voice cracking. This is simply not ideal.
Oh wow, I can already smell it out here. I can already smell the skunk.
All right, boys. Well, we're gonna start off with this little blade bait. Cast out as deep as I can, let her fall to the bottom, and rip her off. I casted that extremely far. I thought the water was gonna be a lot more murky for some reason, because it usually is at this pond, but looks as if it is not, and this fire tiger color probably looks ridiculous right now. But you know what, man? It is what it is. I did not bring any more baits. So we are going with the damn flow. But yeah, letting this boy sink down, you know, ripping her off the bottom, see if we can get a little reaction strike out of these lethargic winter bass. It's very unlikely that I catch a bass today. Let's be optimistic here, even though I'm literally saying the least optimistic comments in the world. God, the Metanium DC is so juicy. Even though, I don't know if you guys saw. Here, I'll throw it on here, actually. I'll throw it in the video real quick. Turn up your volume. I don't understand why my DC reels are making this noise. Metanium is fine, to be honest. I'll throw it on the screen, though. My SLX DC has been broken. I'll throw it up right now. Listen.
All right, boys, go ahead, turn up your sound all the way. Let me know if you guys have ever heard an SLX DC make this noise before.
Haha, gotcha. If you actually just fell for that, I don't really know what to say besides, damn. I'm probably more likely to pull a three-way with Kourtney Kardashian and Caitlyn Jenner right now than catch a bass, but I think we're gonna keep grinding it out, boys. If you guys aren't subscribed, I actually will pop a thing on the screen right now. It looks like 60 or 70% of you motherfuckers aren't subscribed to me, but you watch my videos. I'm doing my Canadian accent right now. I've been watching too much ice fishing. All these guys are very Canadian. I start saying A at the end of my sentences and stuff, and I start liking maple syrup a lot, like all these Canadians, boy, I don't know. Guys, it was literally cold to the point that I was bundled with like five layers the other day, and right now I'm wearing literally just like a fuzzy flannel with nothing under it, like straight skin under it, boys. This is outrageous. Illinois weather's the weirdest thing in the world. We are just gonna cast that baby out, let her sink to the bottom. There's no way I got one. I actually got a fish. No way. Oh my God, it feels good. No, he came off. Oh my gosh. I had a fish so deep out there. Boys, I casted like to the, whoa. Oh my gosh. No way on the blade bait. I cast like across the pond. Oh my gosh, that was the last thing I was expecting. And that just lets me know how deep these fish are gonna be. I figured if there's anyone moving shallow because of this warm weather, I could maybe pick them off with something really small, like a little inline spinner. I never really use inline spinners, but it's like, bro, they're really small. And especially these fish are pushed shallow, looking for some bait to feed up while winter's, you know, about to be here and there's a warm front, you know. They might take a little swipe at it, but dude, I wish I would've gotten that fish in. That fish felt nice too.
We don't care.
Let me tell you.
We don't care.
When you're lazy to get off, slop on your bait. Look at that, every time works like a charm. One more time for shave measure. Cast that thing out to the middle of the pond. Let her sink. Oh, what was that? Oh, I was just getting stuff off my bait. Oh no, it's fine. My daddy owns the lake. No, he does, I swear.
All right.
Karen's, man, I swear.
How would she not know that my daddy owns the lake?
I'm gonna call the local authorities on me.
That is what Karens do.
I see no problems here.